Diego, we have a wonderful treat for you up on our screen. Just give me a moment and I'll get that up for you.
I'm Reverend Edith Washington Woods, senior minister here at Unity St. Everywhere Presence. We give thanks for this day. We ask, dear God, that you
I'm going to start it from the connect. Beginning. There we go.
Good morning, Unity San Diego. I'm Reverend Edith Washington Woods, senior minister here at Unity San Diego, and I want to welcome you here for our Sunday service. I want to also welcome anyone who is watching us via live stream today, and anyone else who may be new. Let us pray. God, the good, omniscience, everywhere presence, we give thanks for this day. We ask, dear God, that you connect us, as only we know that God of our own understanding can do. We're praying in this moment knowing that wherever we are, God is. May we each have a rich experience this morning. And so it is. Amen. And if you'll say our affirmation with me, please, together. Guided by infinite wisdom and prospered by divine love, we move forward in unity to realize our spiritual potential.
Reverend Edith is home with an upper respiratory infection today, so we will be getting that online here. She will be working from home behind the scenes. She'll be answering any questions or saying hello to you from our screen, from our YouTube and our Facebook live screen today. So if you would say with me this morning, please, our vision statement. It's a vision of who we are. A world powerfully transformed through the growing movement of shared spiritual awakening. And then we have our mission statement, and this is how we actually get there. Say this together with me, please. Empowering personal growth through positive spiritual principles, inspirational music, and community service. And now if you would stand and sing, or even from home on your computers, you can see the words for hymn number 72, "Open my eyes that I may see."
Silently now I wait for thee.
role as announcer this morning, we are going to respect the 6 or 10 foot apart, unless we're married, that the county has given us, and just give each other a namaste bow right here. I'm just going to come out and bow to you and just say namaste.
Namaste.
Wishing you health, happiness, and thank you for being here in person at our church and online as a viewer. Now I step into my role as announcer. So the flowers today, these beautiful flowers on the altar, are in honor of Chris. Stand up, Chris. Chris's birthday. If you remember, his wife Billy came. And so we bless you. Let's just give him a blessing. Chris, we love you and we bless you. I don't know this one. We love you, we bless you.
Behold the Christ in you.
I got you. We love you. We bless you. We behold the Christ in you.
And many, many more.
And this year and many, many more. And thank you so much for getting everything on our live streaming, on our YouTube, and here to run our camera today. There are some changes in our announcements. The Interfaith Shelter here is canceled, and the reason it's canceled is due to the county's mandate to have distancing of at least 6 feet apart. And so we just want to thank everyone who stepped up and was willing to volunteer. Thank you so much. The Absolute Abundance Prosperity class that meets on Tuesday morning at 10 and Wednesday evening at 6:30 will now be virtual in a Zoom class. If you have not joined the class and still wish to, please send us over your email address so we can add you to the Zoom screen. Same thing with our Everlasting Serenity group that meets the first, third, and fifth Tuesdays of the month. At least till the end of this month, we will be doing that virtually by Zoom. And the queue process has been rescheduled to April 25th. We'll either be back here or I will learn how to put slides on the screen virtually. So April 25th is the day for the queue process. And this concludes our announcements. Now I invite you to relax and listen to our meditation hymn, number 109, Be Thou My Vision. To be focused. For this sanctuary in your home, wherever you are, is a sacred place. Now, as we join together in meditation, silently allow the words that I speak this morning to be the words of your heart. There may be times and things that happen in our community, in the world around us, things that cause us fear, things that cause us worry, times when we know change is coming. Nothing lasts forever. But when? When will it come? How will it happen? What should I do? When will the chaos around us end? Make a difference. What should I do? What shouldn't I do? Am I calm? Or have I allowed fear and worry to take hold? How can I get these worries, these thoughts, this lack of limitation off of my mind? In times like these, we need to remember to let go and let God. We know that there is a divine light. It shines within each and every one of us, and it guides us, as long as we allow it, in everything that we do. Everything is not always as it appears to be. When we focus on the end result, the end that we want to see, we see peace, we see love, we see help, and a sense of community that has grown strong and desirable. We will be a part of the change that we so desire. As we look beyond limitation, lack, fear, and chaos, and look through our inner eyes, we see divine order. It's at work. It really is clearing a way for a better world. And as we look at life, the challenges we see in our earth with our earthly eyes, when we look beyond that with our Christ eyes, we see love, we see a change, and we make that shift from worry and concern to trust and faith. We know that all truly is well. We are expressions of the divine with a clear heart and a clear mind. We can move from fear to wholeness. We know we do not inherit sickness. We know that God is a love that has no end and a power that knows no bounds. God's healing power of divine light, it's restoring us. It's healing us. And it is revitalizing our world at this very, very moment. We let go of fears. We let go of anxieties. And we affirm that we are safe. We are healthy. We are protected. We bless all those who support us in maintaining vibrant health. we express divine life in all that we do. We bless our family here, ourselves, our community, and our world with peace of mind and abundant love. So let's take a moment now to listen for that voice of divine wisdom, that voice of love, of help, of surety and wholeness, faith and joy in the silence.
morning. For all of you who are here this morning and all of you out there. I did this song more than a month ago, and I couldn't pick a better song for this Sunday. It's talking about the fear that's from outside, and we should not play the fear, we should play against it. And there's always something out there. And then we should remember that love built this building. It's love who mixed the mortar and stacked these stones. Yeah, we should turn away. Right up there. Some team members read the email and others did not. So, yes, just remember, show them. Love will show them.
Together. So it isn't all actuality with both of us. So enjoy. What do you want your year to look like? It's kind of a crazy question today, isn't it? How about your month or your day? What changes would you like to see right now? I know I'd like to see some, wouldn't you? Imagine taking one day at a time, and before you wake up in the morning, envisioning what it is you want. What do you really want? Health, wealth, love, happiness. You might say, well, that's just my imagination. Temptations wrote a song about it. It's just my imagination, right? Shouldn't I live in reality? Shouldn't I be on top of things and like just be right there? Especially with everything happening right now, how can I possibly be in my imagination? But for those younger people who don't know who Albert Einstein is, the German physicist who actually developed the theory of relativity, he said, the true sign of intelligence is not knowledge, but imagination. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that? Imagine what would happen if we could bring into our experience, if we trusted the God of our understanding, if we trusted not only visualizing, but ending this pandemic that has us sequestered in our homes. And we could not only manifest and visualize beyond that, but also we could move forward to a happy and abundant life. Well, you might say, yes, I'm a spiritual being having a human experience. And right now, that human experience is pretty yucky. I don't think it's really good. And you're right, it's not real great right now. But there's more to it. Yes, I am a human, I am a spiritual being having an earthly human experience. But I'm also a spiritual being living in a spiritual universe that is governed by spiritual law. I'm a spiritual being living in a spiritual universe that is governed by spiritual law. Well, what does that mean? Well, this means that the universe is going to bring to us what we focus on, what we dwell on, the thoughts we think, the words we speak, those inner deep beliefs that we have. They'll shape our experience. And as Spirit works in, as, and through each and every one of us, I'd like you to consider, just as I consider, what kind of human experience am I co-creating today? What kind of human experience are our thoughts, our beliefs, our actions, the things we talk about and dwell on? What kind of human experience is that bringing into our awareness? Where is my focus? Where is our focus? Do I want to change it? I do. I'm kind of real sick of hearing about things wrong all the time, aren't you? And I want to move on. I want to have an abundant life. I want to be open and receptive. I want to be to beliefs that are, and I want to get rid of those beliefs that are holding me back. We all have them, right? We all have that belief that, you know, it's not real easy right now, especially when you're in your house and after you clean out everything, you can only clean so much, then you get sick of being in your house, and then you go to the store and you gotta stand in line, people are fighting over toilet paper, and they're hoarding and all this lack of limitation. We were at the store the other day, some lady had 45 cans of soup in her cart. And you wonder, what the heck is going on? How can I look beyond this lack of limitation? What should I do? And then we wonder, what and how can I become a channel of peace and abundance? Well, I'd like to read a poem out of this book from one of our congregants, Michael Thomas. He's one of our board members. The book is called Let Me Offer You a Rainbow. And it's a plea for unity. I'm going to read it out of the book, but it's also on the screen. Open to love. If you'll be filled with divine light, with unconditional love, with greater life, empty yourself first of your judgments, of your misunderstandings, of your preconceptions. Open yourselves that love and understanding might fill you. Isn't that beautiful? You might want to check him out for this book. It's full of lovely, wonderful things. A plea for unity. And isn't that what we want? Unity here, correct? So are you willing to open up and let your life be full of love? And how can we accomplish this? Because that's not really easy. Seems easy, sounds easy, but it's not always easy. So I'd like to talk to you about visualization, the power of visualization. When we were kids, we visualized a lot, right? I'm gonna kind of age myself here, so. You know, we might have dressed up like Cinderella. We might have played cowboys and Indians. Kids today are, you know, Frozen and, you know, Buzz Lightyear and everything. Well, when I was about 8 years old, there was this show on TV called The Man from U.N.C.L.E. Anybody watch that? Yeah, I love that show. And you know, I went in my basement because I lived in Chicago at the time, and I had like my little secret agent area. And so I wasn't just wanting to be a secret agent. See, I was a secret agent. Yeah, I was. And I walked around with these little secret coders, and I wrote with invisible ink, which was in my day was lemon juice. And I had all these messages all over the house for people to try to decipher. And it was just so real for me that I wanted to become that person that helped others. I wanted to become that person that was the hero that could stand up for other people. When I was 13 years old, I was at my sister's house and I read this book. And this book talked all about this wonderful new housing program called Section 8. Were we gonna do it? What was gonna happen? How wonderful would it be to have Section 8 to help single mothers, people that couldn't afford their rent payments? How wonderful. It was unheard of when I was 13. So I thought about it. I visualized apartments. I visualized houses. Then I kind of threw it away. Yeah, whatever. Then in my late 40s, really aging myself now, my late 40s, my husband and I decided to start flipping apartments. And we said, hey, let's get into Section 8. Took a while for that visualization to happen, but it happened. Now, even today, we still have apartments that serve people that need Section 8. And what a blessing it is, not only for us as landlords to just have a place, but to help people that need that help and to provide a nice, clean, safe home for people. What an imagination. Really paid off, didn't it? That visualization that I had no idea that day in my sister's kitchen would really become a reality. And I forgot to put his poem up there, I apologize. So, visualization is daydreaming with a purpose. And when we visualize with a purpose, then we can change our lives and change our beliefs, such as unity principle number 3. I create my experiences by what I choose to think and what I feel and believe. You know, visualization has been proven by science to be an effective tool in people becoming successful. Athletes use it, even in situations that people think are hopeless. I was watching on the History Channel last week about food and how food, it's all about chocolate, that's really why I watched it. But it did have Colonel Sanders on there and how he had started his chicken business. Well, Harlan Sanders, now we know him as Colonel Sanders, was fired from a variety of jobs his entire life. He didn't start cooking chicken until he was about 40 years old. And he would serve it out of his kitchen in a gas station in the 1930s. It took him about 10 years to actually get a restaurant. And what he did was he had seen a pressure cooker someplace on a magazine or something from Europe. And so he wanted to develop a pressure cooker that would cook fried chicken in the bulk that he needed it. It's just amazing watching this. So he visualized it and he tried it over and over and over again. Finally, he was able to cook pretty good chicken. So he moved to his restaurant in the 50s, and then city put in a freeway, and he had to move. So he was so worried how he was going to survive, because he had been so worried about frying chicken, he hadn't saved much money. So he only had a pension of $105 a month. So he went around trying to sell his pieces of chicken for 5 cents each. Finally, he found somebody to partner with him. And that visualization, that imagination that he had when he was in the kitchen developing that crock pot or that pressure cooker, caused him now to have one of the biggest franchises in the world. Another person, Jim Carrey. How many people love Jim Carrey, the Grinch? I love him. In the early 80s, he was really a pretty unknown actor. So he says, and I've watched him say it myself, that to stay motivated, he wrote himself a check for $10 million, and he dated it 1994. He carried that through the 80s, all the way through 1994, and he would look at it every day. $10 million, and on the bottom he put for acting services rendered, right there in that little memo line. So in 1994, Jim Carrey did the movie Dumb and Dumber, which is pretty funny. And guess how much he earned in 1994? $10 million. It's possible, right? It's possible. But you know, visualization, you don't even have to be anywhere or do anything for it to work. If you're unable to leave your surroundings, it can also help you. Back in the 80s, there was this computer specialist named Nathan Sharansky. And he spent 9 years in prison because he was in the USSR and they thought he was spying for the United States. The whole time he was there, he was in solitary confinement. He was playing chess with himself over and over and over to keep himself motivated. And he would say, well, I might as well use this as the opportunity to become a world chess champion. Guess what happened after he was released in 1986? He beat the world champion. His name was Garry Kasparov. And he beat him in a game of chess and became the world champion. Wow. Oprah Winfrey says, create the highest, grandest vision possible for your life because you become what you believe. Again, isn't that like Unity Principle number 3? I create my experiences by what I choose to think and what I feel and what I believe. And you know, new science, amazing science proves that just like we knew in New Thought, that we can, the same mental instructions that we give when we're pretending or imagining, it's the same thing as when we're actually doing a physical action. So let's take this one step further, knowing that visualization is daydreaming with a purpose. Let's make a vision board, or what Reverend Kevin Daigle would call an I am map. Now this map is more than a vision of what we want. This map is spiritually inspired because it helps us open our consciousness into what we want to bring into our life, into which I know, for me and I'm sure for all of you, is unlimited good. Here's an I am map, and I don't know how well people can see it, so I am going to describe it to you. And it's actually a wonderful thing to do. It's kind of like a vision board. We've done some vision boards, but it's a little bit deeper. So visualize with me, if you would, a big piece of cardboard or a large piece of paper. Think of various magazines that you might have, maybe a Daily Word, House of Better Homes and Gardens, maybe some family magazines that you might have on your table, or some positive affirmations and sayings you might have. What images would you put on your map? What sayings resonate with you? What images resonate with you? A person? Perhaps a new home? New car? Perhaps a trip? Pretty soon we can all go on our trips. And then make sure to include your image of the God of your understanding. So maybe that's a picture of the universe, or maybe it's someone meditating. Maybe it's a candle or someone doing yoga. You can see up here the chakras, somebody doing yoga with the chakras. What affirmations are we including? What I am are you saying? I am healthy. I am wealthy. I am prosperous. Visualize that piece of cardboard with the most powerful image that you have of the divine right in the middle. And then going out from that middle and expressing in different ways is everything that you want manifested in your life. Because we know spirit and the God of our understanding is our source, don't we? So that's where we need to begin. Then every day, put your map somewhere where you can look at it. Maybe to your, put it in your restroom, put it by the front door, take it to work with you. But look at it and know that this is a positive collage. This is a positive way of visualizing, tactically handling it with our hands and making it. So we're thinking it, we're saying it, we're writing it, and we're looking at it. And know, like they say in Luke 1:37, in the easy to read Bible, God can do anything. Doesn't get any easier than that, right? If we just let go. If we only let go, what a wonderful positive activity we can have by making an I am map, by seeing and living in our positivity and knowing that God, the God of our understanding, can do anything. I have an affirmation up here I'd like to use with you. I'll say it, and then one time if you would repeat it after me after I say it first. I use the power of visualization to manifest the life I want. Say that with me, please. I use the power of visualization to manifest the life I want. Let's say that one more time and really mean it, because we're going to be sitting home for a lot of days here, and I want to do more than clean my closets, don't you? Let's visualize what we want so we can get past what we don't want. Let's say it with our hands on our heart. I use the power of visualization to manifest the life I want. And as you move through your day, through your week, I invite you to meditate on these truths. I am abundant. Say that with me. I am abundant. Prosperity flows freely in my direction. Let's say that together. Let's start again. Ready? Prosperity flows freely in my direction. I am open to receive all the resources I need. I am open to receive all the resources I need. All that I'm working towards is manifesting now. All that I am working towards is manifesting now. You see, as we look to spirit for the source of all good, we know that God, nothing is impossible. So it is. Let us pray. Mother, Father, God, sweet, sweet Spirit, we know that you are in charge. There is a blessing. There is a blessing in each and every situation. There is a blessing that pulls us forward into community, into love, into help, into helping one another, and into manifesting the way that we would like our love and our life to be, our family's life, our friends, our community, the nation, and the world. So it is. Please join me, LL, in special music in singing I Am One with Everything Around Me.
Well, let's stand and sing. Might be good to stand at home too. Get the blood.
Stand at home. Words will be on the screen. All right. So now's our time of giving and receiving. So we have a basket right here placed in the middle of the pews for you to walk up and place your tithe in the basket. For those that are watching on live stream, please click on the donate button where you're watching. We now have PayPal. So you can pay with PayPal, a credit card, or a debit card. It's much easier than it was before. So let's say our blessing twice out loud and once in the silence. But before I do that, I'm going to tell you about our prayer opportunities. We have many prayer opportunities here at Unity San Diego. They include prayer workers from noon to 9, Monday through Friday. There's cards in the chairs and pews right here where you can write a prayer request. And today's prayer chaplains may be Patty, who's not here, but Akosua, who is. And know that they are holding a sacred space for you. For those watching online, there are prayer chaplains that are holding sacred space. Please contact one of them, and Reverend Edith is putting the phone number on the chat bar right now. Call the prayer line here at Unity San Diego, or you can call Silent Unity, and she's putting those in the comments section right now. Now, if we can take our offering in our hands and say our offering blessing twice out loud and once in the silence. I am one with God's gifts. They overflow and enrich my life. I bless the gifts and share from infinite good. Once more. I am one with God's gifts. They overflow and enrich my life. I bless the gifts and share from infinite good. Just take that one time into the silence. We know that we are here in a place where we are spiritually fed, and we are so grateful and so abundantly, abundantly thankful to be able to be here in person, here online, to have our spiritual community, and to give where we are spiritually fed. And so it is. Amen.
As you can see, the choir has been on hiatus for the rest of the month, and hopefully they'll be back for Easter. But I get the chance to sing this wonderful song by Michael Dodd with Kathy. So this is Spirit in Me. Is the image of your love.
you. That was so beautiful. I want to take the time to honor and to just say a prayer over our offerings. But I first want to take a moment to thank our music team for coming here despite everything so that we can have a service here for you, so that we can put it online. Ron adjusted songs so that we can go ahead and publish them and show them online. They practiced new songs. They came here. They're sitting kind of close to each other. I think they're around each other a little bit because they do a lot of work together. But look how they are tithing with their time and their talent to our wonderful spiritual community. Let's just give them a hand. Thank you so much. And I know you just worked on that song because that was a real quick one. Thank you. Wonderful job. So let's just take a moment to bless in prayer all these offerings. We know, God, that we are here to be your presence. We are here to be your feet, your word. We speak your truth. We are here to continue no matter what, letting people and letting others know just how wonderful and how much our thoughts, our feelings, and the things that we bring into our life can change our world, can change what is happening, just not just for us, but for everyone. And we honor these offerings, these tithes, these monetary gifts that came here in this basket at church, but also online through our virtual viewers. We thank you all because this is what will keep us moving forward. As we become a bigger online presence, and as we become a bigger community, and as we prepare at the end of this month to, or a little after that, to move back into our church home, your offerings of love are helping us move forward. And we say thank you, thank you, thank you, God. And so it is. And I'd also like now to bless our prayer box. We do have our prayer chaplain, Okla. I'm going to stand back here, and she's going to put it on the table or hold it over there. I will bless her as our board has asked us to stay as far apart as we can, just so that we are complying and so that we don't happen to spread anything. So these prayers, these affirmations, these gifts and requests are in that box for 30 days. They're prayed over by our prayer team up on the sixth floor. They're prayed for every day. And not only these prayers, but the prayers in our hearts, the prayers that we've put online, or maybe we've written a prayer and put it in our offering basket, or we're typing one in today. These prayers are all part of what we were made on. Unity was founded on prayers. We know, God, that prayer works. We know that prayer doesn't change outwards experiences, it changes us. And as it changes us in the way that we think and the way that we believe and the things that we bring into our experience, then outer things do change because we focus on the positive. We bring into our awareness that which will help us manifest and become the abundant creatures, the abundant people that God of our understanding has always wanted us to be. And so we bless these prayers, and we say thank you, God. And so it is. And now we can stand and sing the peace song. We are not going to hold hands, but we are going to either namaste or hold our hand on our hearts or dance or whatever, but let's sing the peace song. Let there be peace on earth. for protection. Let's say it together. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. And all is truly well. I wish you all love, peace, joy, happiness, and wealth, and the time to enjoy these many, many blessings. Namaste. You are not alone. We are here together. And we will be working here during the week. And just feel free to give us a call. Call Reverend Edith. Give me a call. You are not alone. Thank you. Namaste.